Today's story is Anything But Ordinary Addie, the true story of Adelaide Herrman, Queen of Magic, written by Mara Rockliff, illustrated by Iacopo Bruno. Addie never wanted to be ordinary. Addie wanted to astonish, shock, and dazzle. One day, she saw an advertisement in the newspaper. Wanted, young ladies to learn dancing. Secretly, she sewed herself a dancing dress and joined the troupe. When Addie told her family what she was doing, they were shocked. Our Addie? On the stage? In front of everyone in tights? But then they saw her dance, and Addie was astonishingly good. Addie liked being a prima ballerina. Still, floating gracefully across the stage felt just the tiniest bit ordinary. Lots of girls could dance, Addie told herself, but how many dared hop on the newfangled invention called the bone shaker? That's what they called bikes when they were first invented. Soon Addie could be seen pedaling merrily around in the most shocking costume, doing extraordinary tricks. Addie dazzled crowds in London, Brussels, and Paris. Next thing Addie knew, she found herself crossing the ocean to America. On board the ship, she met an elegant young man. His name was Alexander, but the world knew him as Herrman the Great. Addie was dazzled by him. She told Alexander she would like to marry him. Young lady proposing to a gentleman? The other girls were shocked. How bold, Addie, you can't. It simply isn't done. And astonished when Alexander said yes. The mayor of New York himself performed the wedding ceremony. But how do you pay his fee? Fortunately, money had a way of turning up for the Hermans. Alexander was no ordinary husband. He set fire to Addie. He chopped off her head. He made her vanish, poof, into thin air. The two of them got along splendidly. Together, they astonished. They shocked and dazzled audiences around the globe. They hired more performers for their show. A juggler, a family of tumblers, a ventriloquist, and the beautiful Geraldine, who climbed into a cannon's mouth and boom! One night, Geraldine vanished. Poof! It wasn't part of the act. She had run off before the audience had arrived. Shoot me from the cannon, Addie offered. Alexander was shocked. Addie wasn't an acrobat. She'd never tried this trick. Still, they both knew that the show must go on, so... Even Addie was a bit astonished when she landed safely in the net. Almost nothing frightened Addie. One thing, only one, could make her tremble in her spangled slippers, was the bullet-catching trick. Very few magicians had ever mastered this thrilling, death-defying act. It dazzled audiences, but it terrified Addie. It was truly dangerous. Magicians had been killed when it went wrong. Addie begged Alexander not to do the trick. At last he agreed, and Addie felt happy knowing her husband was safe. Fate had a shock up its sleeve. One night, on the train to a performance, Alexander's heart quietly gave out. He had a heart attack. This time, there would be no astonishing escape from death. For Addie, the magic had vanished. Yet, she knew that without Herrman the Great, all the other performers would be out of work. Shows would be canceled and closed. Theater managers would lock their doors and disappointed children would be turned away. No, the show must go on. But how? I will do it myself, Addie announced. Everyone was shocked. A woman magician? Who ever heard of such a thing? No one will come. Addie had never cared what others thought, but now she was worried they were right. What if nobody came? Addie knew she could do anything Herrman the Great had done. She could pull rabbits from the air. She could make a bright shower of oranges and candies rain onto the stage. She could turn a painting of a beautiful young girl into a real girl and then back again. But if an audience didn't appear, poof, it wouldn't matter what Addie could do. She needed an act so shocking, so astonishing, so dazzling, thrilling, and death-defying, no one could stay home. Can you guess what trick she'd need to use? It had to be the bullet-catching trick. The night came. The theater was packed. Addie stood alone facing a squadron of soldiers, loaded rifles raised. Ready? Addie held up a fragile china plate. Several frightened men rushed for the exit. Aim! A woman screamed and fainted. Addie trembled but stood firm. Fire! Ladies and gentlemen, Adelaide Herrman, the Queen of Magic. Do you see the bullet on the plate? Thanks to Addie, the show did go on for 30 more years. Addie created many dazzling, astonishing tricks of her own. No one could ever guess what new illusion she had up her sleeve. But Addie being Addie, everybody knew for sure it would be anything but ordinary. Some more about Addie the Great. Once upon a time, the world's most famous magicians were named Herrman. There was Carl Herrman, his much younger brother Alexander, their nephew Leon, and of course the Queen of Magic, Alexander's widow Adelaide. Adelaide was born Adelaide Scarsese in London on August 11, 1853. Addie's parents were Belgian, and she and her older siblings grew up speaking French, a skill that came in handy when Addie met a handsome Parisian magician on a ship. Addie and Alexander had a lot in common. They were both bold and adventurous. They both adored animals, pets they collected on their travels and used in their show to make them disappear like rabbits and chickens and pigs and macaws and chameleons. And they both had a way of making audiences fall in love with them the instant they appeared on stage. In her 65 years of magic, Adelaide met everyone in show business. The silent film star Buster Keaton played vaudeville with her when he was 6 years old. Adelaide counted as friends the actress Sarah Bernhard, songwriter Oscar Hammerstein, the showman P.T. Barnum, and Buffalo Bill Cody. When Addie died in 1932, her funeral was crowded with magicians. Over her coffin, they solemnly broke her magic wand. The queen was gone. If you want to know more about the secrets of the bullet-catching trick, it's revealed on www.mararockliff.com/bullet.html.